Well, Ottawa spreads 175,000 tons of road salt on its highways, roads, and sidewalks each winter. We just heard Alistair Seal tell us about that. That's more than any municipality in the country. And, of course, it makes walking and driving in the city safer. But according to Health Canada, it's not safe for the environment, and an Ottawa entrepreneur wants the city to try an alternative that he's developed. But he says he's been hitting roadblocks. Mark Watson is the founder of Earth Innovations, and he joins me this morning in studio. Good to see you. Good morning.
Hey, good morning.
So you've been at this for about 5 years trying to get the city to do, I guess, a pilot project. But before we get to sort of what the pitch is, tell me how the product works exactly, how it's different.
Sure. EcoTraction, it's an all-natural volcanic mineral. It's a very porous mineral. And it basically absorbs a thin layer of water on the surface of ice and embeds itself, creating a sandpaper effect so that you don't slip and fall. It's not a chemical ice melter. It's more of a very grippy type of substance. So, for example, when you have grip tape at a swimming pool step, it would provide that sort of effect to prevent you from slipping.
It almost sort of sounds like a compromise between, I know, for example, in Calgary, they use a lot of gravel there. They throw dirt on the road, essentially, and you got a bunch of dirty cars as a result.
True.
Here they do salt, and this sort of seems like a marriage between the two. It softens up the ice, but then embeds and becomes provides traction, essentially.
Exactly. It doesn't have some of the dust issues with the salt and sand and rock, which Calgary is complaining about, it, as is Edmonton.
Yeah.
But it doesn't have the chloride toxin problem with all the ice melters either. So it's about 50% lighter than rock and sand, softer, and provides 35% better traction than sand if you use five times less.
Now, you've got some supporters out there because NCC wants to do a pilot with this, as I understand it.
Well, they were certainly open to testing it along the Rideau Canal when we inquired with them last year.
And the Canadian Federation of Municipalities is interested in this as well, is that right?
Well, they have a grant program that we applied for, and they were very open and receptive, and they thought that, from the people we talked to, that this would definitely pass. It was structured in such a way that there'd be upwards of $300,000 available for the City of Ottawa to test a sustainable product such as EcoTraction. It just required the city's consent to move forward.
So the Federation was supportive of the City of Ottawa doing a pilot?
Yeah,
just so I've got this straight, they're not suggesting that you do pilots at municipalities across the country, but they would support and provide funding if Ottawa decided to do a pilot with this. Is that right?
They have an application process, a two-phase application process. The first phase is the city interested in doing this trial? Mm-hmm. And phase two, what are the details? We couldn't even get to phase one. The city would not even, acknowledge that, yes, they were interested in doing apply for this grant in the first place. They didn't feel that the project was worthwhile considering. So therefore, the grant wasn't able to proceed to phase two.
Mark, are there any municipalities in the country doing pilots with this product?
Currently, there's, as far as we know, there's about a dozen municipalities that have tried it at various levels.
Mm-hmm.
In the States, we have City of Chicago that is using it in their parks. For example, also New York, Saranac Lake has been using it. A number of cities that have expressed interest in it.
Especially what about in Canada?
In Canada, Charlottetown has used it. Walkerton has tested it. They have water issues. Mm-hmm. Waterloo has been doing some testing. Even parts of City of Ottawa, like I know, for example, some of the community centers have been using it to great success.
So you've got a number of locations that are testing it. And so when does the verdict come back? I'm just trying to get a sense of where the process is.
Well, I think the verdict is that EcoTraction works. We have hundreds of thousands of Canadian consumers out there that are using it and that are happy with the product.
They can buy it at the retail level commercially.
Right. And we also have corporate Canada that's adopted it. We have companies like Rogers Communications, Air Transat, Irving, Suncor, Syncrude, big corporate Canada using it as part of their lead initiatives. It's just municipal governments that aren't sort of recognizing that, hey, this is a viable alternative. And they're the ones that stand the most to benefit from it because they're the by far the largest users of salt in the country.
Now, the city, we did ask for an interview, we should point out, and we weren't provided with anybody to respond to this. But what they did do is send us a document saying that they get lots of pitches to try out new products, and they expect companies to do their own field tests.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, we did, with the National Research Council, we did some testing, which, again, proved positive. We did testing with Carleton University's research lab. They actually have an environmental and engineering department in the city of Ottawa, the second coldest capital in the country. And our research there demonstrated that it worked. It's really a question now of rolling out, a small-scale test with their equipment, with a decent amount. I mean, the city of Ottawa, for example, uses 10,000 truckloads of salt. If we used maybe, 10 or even 100 truckloads, which is just, a minor amount, they would get a feel as to whether or not this works.
Yeah, it would be a lot less. Well, what about cost? What's the difference in cost between this product and using salt?
Well, if we look at on a per ton basis, it's about five times more expensive. On the other hand, if we look at the real cost of salt, the salt pays about $75 a ton, but the real cost of salt, according to some university studies, is about $900 a ton when you count the incremental damage to our roads, our bridges, our parks, our public infrastructure. So the real cost is $975 a ton. By that measure, it's about half the price. Now, if we factor in that our product goes nine times further, ours becomes significantly cheaper.
You use less of it, quite a lot less.
Yes, about nine times less, if spread correctly.
Well, it doesn't. I'm taking a look at the front page of The Citizen today and taking a look at what happened on the 417, 2 centimeters of snow, 46 collisions, and 10 snarled salt trucks. Hey,
right.
Add up to, as they put it, one hell of a commute.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, you have a new council. Does that make a difference, do you think? You say you've been trying to get traction with council for 5 years. Might you have better luck with a new council?
Yeah,
new
I mayor? Think we're quite hopeful that, Mayor Watson, with his new environmental person, will take a much more active role in preserving our waters. We have seven rivers flowing through the city that are being contaminated by this, and I know Mayor Watson wants to make protecting the waters around Ottawa one of his legacy items. So I'm hoping, it will be more than words and they will put this into action because this is a viable alternative, especially for eco-sensitive areas like near our rivers, our parks, our historic buildings.
And what about your councillor?
Well, I'm going to be meeting with Mr. Eli Chantiri this week, and I'm hoping that he will be supportive of it, especially around the eco-sensitive areas like the Rideau Canal. I'm hoping he'll support a trial, and we'd also like him to support things like having the police, the Ottawa police, carry this product in their cruisers, and maybe OC Transpo use it on their buses for when the passengers are getting on the buses. Ultimately, there's about $160 million in savings a year to be realized in public infrastructure damage. That money could be used so much better elsewhere in the city.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it there. Really interesting, though, Mark. Keep us informed on how this proceeds.
Well, thank you very much. Thanks for your interest.
That's Mark Watson, founder of Earth Innovations and Development of EcoTraction.